Hello everyone and welcome back to the 7 Deadly Sins Grand Cross. So today we have the start of a new and exciting collaboration, which is with the Attack on Titan series, which I probably know a lot about since I follow the manga really closely every month, and I also watch the anime, of course. So there is much to say, also because unfortunately the global company made some unwanted changes to the event for both the gacha and some stages. So I will start with the gameplay aspect that got changed. So we had a stage where you could farm awakening stones, which are used into the equipment power up. And this stage was infinite, so you could have do it how many times you wanted. But they decided to limit it to 3 times a day for global. That is really, really bad, because you're limiting the player experience that the Japanese server got from this event. And I can find no reason to do this other than wanting players to waste more time farming for those things and probably spend more money to get resources and other stuff that help to farm the Awakening Stones. So, I must say, coming into this collab, I am already unhappy about this thing. Second thing, we have a gacha. This gacha is the same in Japan side. However, since they have more adventurers or heroes, if you will, than us when this collab released, we get some really, really bad heroes on rate up. How bad? Let me show you. So the rates are up here. So as you can see, we have Mikasa, Levi and Eren, which I want to try and get all three. Then we have Deldry, Deathpierce, Elaine, Arthur, Red Hellbram, Gil Thunder and Jericho. So, as you can see, if you get unlucky, if you don't manage to get them, you get one of these... should I call them trash? Should I call them bad? I think trash and bad is the right word. You will get one of these trash and bad 4-star adventurers, which doesn't make sense because... like, the 3 collab heroes are already decent, they are not bad because they're not bad, they're decent. And then you put trash heroes in the banner alongside them, instead of putting, I don't know, some recently released characters, like, for example, the old Ten Commandments, the old Melascula, or the old Galland. You could put some Gouder, some Red Gouder, some Ban, I don't know. You could put anything way more decent than those characters, but instead you choose to put them. Will this mean that I will pull one of those characters? Most likely I will pull Gil Thunder, because he has been probably a curse in my heart since the start of this game, and Elaine as well. And that sucks. That really, really sucks. There is no other way around it. There is no step up, which is another thing that I don't understand for collabs, since it is a really well done system if they actually used it. However, we have an SSR guarantee at 300 loyalty points, which, if I'm not wrong, should be 300 temples, so it should be, I don't know how many crystals, way too many, just let's put it that way. And at the top you can get one of the new adventurers with 600 loyalty points, which is still a ton. So what else is there to say? I really don't enjoy this. It is one of the main reasons why I don't play this game so much. It's because it is way too greedy and way too predatory with its systems. And even if I love the game itself, the stories, the gameplay and so on, the fact that every time I log in there is a new banner that has a power crept unit that kills the unit from the previous banner, the fact that every time the progression goes at 200% speed and I am basically 2 months behind the current players, it's really bad. So this was a bit of a rant about the game. I also wanted to add that this game is in the top 10 revenue for the first 6 months of the year. And the games like Dragalia, who I cover in this channel, and who many who play it know that it's a really generous game with a ton of really good quality of life decision. Most of all, a new decision that basically gives you free items to unbind your characters from stages from the stories coming to the game, which is basically a way to say you don't need to roll the gacha to get extra units. Like, and instead, this game wants you to pay money. Listen to this, they want you to pay money to get the extra dress for the collab characters. You don't get them for free like the Tensura collab. You need to pay 27 euros for one. Listen to this, for one, not even all of them, for one dress for your character. And if you don't do that, your character will always be weaker than the average character from this game, because the average character can buy their deaths for 30 diamonds. So I don't understand that. I really don't. Like, it's fine to put them for sale and then you put them for diamonds. However, only for sale, and then I am basically screwed because I can't buy them, because they are gone and I can't spend money or instead. That doesn't make sense. Why should I even pull for the characters? So already I can tell you that you shouldn't pull on this banner, you shouldn't spend at all on this event, and you should send them feedback to say that this is probably one of the worst decisions they made on the game, and there have been a ton of bad decisions that they made in the game since the first collab that we had. Ok, so now my anger got out and kinda monopolized the first part of the video. Let's try to get back in shape and do this gacha right. So I want to try and get Mikasa because she's my favorite character. And Eren, I can't really tell you much without spoiling, but I have sort of mixed feelings about him. I really like the character. However, when you read the manga, some stuff gets explored, let's say. Levi, I really think he's cool. As for the character, I mean, he's a character where you really want to enjoy the fact that he's cooler rather than the character itself. He has some funny stuff like his obsession over cleaning, but I'm fine with not getting him if I am at that point. Anyway, let's try and use all of our gems, because the idea was that I would get enough gems for a step up, but it's not a step up, so let's see what we get. Once again, I will repeat that I have no idea about the game animations for when you pull a character that you want, and that I know that I add the SSR guarantee on top, but I don't think this applies on this banner. If I'm wrong, we will see. If I'm wrong and we get a collab character, I am more than happy. You can be sure about that. You might ask, why are you rolling on the gacha? Because after what you said, it is mainly because I am collecting characters at this point. I'm not planning to do competitive content for PvP. I am slowly rising on the ranks, but just because I want to get the weekly gems, not because I want to compete. And for the rest of the game, I'm not really doing the final boss. They are tedious. They require you to build a ton of characters, which it would take ages for me. So far I'm just progressing slowly. I will probably reach at some point a level where I can do every content, but right now that's not the case. Anyway, as usual, we got the first pull, first shaft. Nothing else to see here. Let's see if we get the 4-star guaranteed or if it's only for some banners. Ok, so let me check. It's 30 for one 10 pull. So 10 temples should be one guaranteed SSR. We add 280. We lack. Sorry, no, we don't lack, or we do. Yes, we lack because we will need 300 diamonds. So I am one short of a SSR guarantee. Hopefully, we don't need it. I probably will farm it off video just in case because a guarantee it's still better than anything else. I probably expect that I will need to farm for it. This game, I probably never pulled a character that I want in a gacha video for this game. I could make assumptions, but I don't want to because I am already mad as it is about the stuff that they did with the collab, so I won't. However, wait, we got something. Let's see if it is a character that we want. Hopefully it is. So, come on. Let us have Mikasa. Come on. Heck. And there it is. There is what I was saying earlier. So you want to pull for the collab characters? Let me re-explain. 0.5%, so they are on rate up, and you get this trash. This is what you get. So this is why you should never pull on this banner. Even if you like the characters, it's not worth it. This is trash, this is complete trash. This is beyond... this is beyond bad. Like, when I get... off-pull characters on other games, I am happy because they don't limit the pull, you know? I can get even the best characters or the worst characters, characters that I already have, or characters that I don't have and that I wanted to pull back then. Here instead you just get trash. Trash that you already got because those characters get forced on you all the time, because they are on every banner, because they know that they are bad. They release them knowing that they are bad. They are there just to push you into pulling, so that you get another copy of these characters, your pity rate resets, and then you get this trash. I have no words about this. This is completely, completely stupid. I don't understand it, and I don't want to understand it, because there is nothing to understand about it. Like, I really can't get better games to play than this after this stuff. Like, I probably will do the collab, the story and so on, and then I will move on from this game until they decide to fix stuff, because it is really embarrassing to have such obvious scammy systems in a game like this. An high quality game, a really good game, a game that started with decent monetization, and instead they saw that they made money, so they say, why not push it even further, why not be even more scammy than we can be? And they did it, they didn't care. They didn't care to listen, they didn't care to fix. They just did it. And I fully expected that after this collab we will get probably the Rieri banner. And the Rieri is one of the most powerful characters in the game. And she's one that players have saved up a lot for. So, what's the best plan? You make players spend for this collab, then you release another really good character, so players who have spent on this collab will have to spend once again, because you can't miss up on that really good PvP character that has a rate up only now. You can't do that. So, Batman. Once again, let me tell you, we just went through 50 temples and we got one trash character. We got no collab character, not even the SR Eren that hopefully should be in this banner as well, like the slime Rimuru. But so far, no sign of him. You seen him, guys? I haven't seen him. Like, I wanted to start the day with a smile, you know, like, finally we got a new exciting update to the game with a new exciting collab, we can pull, we have a ton of gems, etc. Instead we get trash, even more trash, and the banner sucks. The banner sucks. I can probably get one single collab character out of this, probably one I will get. Likely I will get Levi, which is the one that I don't need. I want him, but I don't need him. Ah, but they gave us a free Benimaru. They did, and that was good. However, here, what they will do? They will give us a free Levi just to say, sorry guys for putting all this scummy stuff in the game. Ooh. Seems we got another 4 star, guys. Are you ready for the next Mompiers? No, okay, even if you defeat the demon, it's not a guaranteed 4 star. I don't understand the bulk of this game, I really don't. I hopefully one day I will, though, let me tell you that. Ooh, Mikasa, nice! Nice. Redemption arc for this banner. At least the waste of gems that I've been doing isn't for nothing. But the point still remains. It's not... you know, he got what he wanted, now he won't criticize it anymore. It stays completely the same. Remember, I already told you this back then. In at the 1 year anniversary, we will get an awakening system for the characters, which requires you to have 6 copies of the character. So eventually, even if you plan to use Mikasa, which I plan to, like I do for Milim, Rimuru and Benimaru, she will get useless. Also, she doesn't have her costumes unless you pay. So, she's severely underpowered compared to the other characters. So there isn't, you know, now I'm happy. There is, there just is. I'm happy as a collector. Now my account still has probably most of the characters from every collab. I just need to get Eren and Levi and then... Why do you like to collect? I don't know. A lot of people like to collect stuff. Many collect... another 4-star, nice. Many collect stamps, some collect bottle caps. I like to collect cards. Ooh, let's see what it is. Nice, we got Eren. Okay. So far, has gotten better. People like to collect the bottle caps, some like to collect stamps and so on. I like to collect cards. I like to collect Pokemon cards when I was young. However, that got really pricey really fast, especially since they started to really ramp up the their monetization stuff with the cards themselves. Every now and then I buy some product, but I don't really give up with it. So I said to myself, what's the best way to keep being a collector right now? And I saw Gacha, and I think Gacha, if you play them as a free-to-play, they are fun to collect because you can kinda strategize around the free gems, the pulls, the guaranteed pulls, etc. And I enjoyed it. They are also most of the time RPGs, which is one of my favorite gaming genres. So it was a match made in heaven. When it happens like this, however, I get reminded that there are companies behind this type of games that don't care if you want a fair game, they just want to make money. And I understand that, I don't blame them for wanting to make money. But when this game was already doing well before this collab came out, I can kinda say, you know, you don't need to steep so low just to make money. You already are doing it really well from before, like, you don't need to be so scummy. But they did, so, you know. Hopefully after this collab they manage to fix this behavior and I will come back to this game and appreciate it more. So this kind of answer the question on why I wasn't playing so much lately. It's just because I can't enjoy a game like this because, you know, like for example, I spent 90 gems to power up my Valentine. I bought all the costumes that I liked. And then a banner with Melascula came out and I kinda wanted to pull for that. However, I had to make a choice. Do I want to get another character which I will need 30 hours to power up, or do I want to buy those costumes which I will use because Valentine is my most powerful character? That is fine because gems, there are a ton of gems for free. However, when you get to a point where now I also have to consider whatever to use gems for progression or for Gacha, it kinda turns me off, if I'm honest. That's personal rather than a complaint, so don't take it as a bad side of the game. I think the fact that you can buy costumes with gems is probably good, because most games require you to pay for skins, so let's be fair about that. However, I don't like choosing progression over Gacha. Like, I'd like to choose a progression where playing the game made me progress rather than using paid currency, if I'm honest. So, that's what I think about it. I am speaking up because the video is taking kinda long. I wanted to assure you all because you already know the answer. If I haven't said it enough, I will say it again later. I will make a timestamp of the should you all. Big answer, no, you shouldn't. You should probably wait until they fix this stuff, not do like I'm doing and wasting my gems for nothing, because I got 2 copies of the collab characters in over, I think it is 90 pulls, so... Ah, of course, this is good, don't get me wrong, there will be people that got 0, that probably got 3 Monspierre or 3 Deldry from this, so this actually is good, those are good pulls, don't get me wrong. However, it could be A lot worse. Could be really be. It's a shame, you know. I really don't want Tales of Crestoria, which recently released to go the same way. Hopefully it doesn't. Let's see what it is. Arthur, another off-banner character who is pointless because he is useless. He's actually good in some comps, however, you can buy him from the shop, which makes him completely useless. But it's fine, we didn't get Levi, which is the one that I usually don't get in the Attack on Titan collabs, if I'm honest. In the Dammemo collab, I only got Eren and Mikasa, so... And Armin, too. We had also Armin on the Dammemo collab. Dammemo is a game that probably does what this game tries to do way better. Like, when... I am in a shortage of currency, I don't feel like I was trashed. I just feel like I was unlucky and that's it. Oh, man. Okay. So, should you pull? I will just tell you quick information about the units. The best unit is Eren, because he's the first transforming unit in the game. He can transform into a Titan when you use his ulti. And when you transform, his damage gets amazing. However, remember, to pull off an ulti, you need to fill up the orbs. In PvP, that's almost impossible, because the enemy knows what your unit does, and will try to get in your way to power them up and to transform Eren into a Titan. So, he's good probably for clearing content in PvE, so he's the best unit on the banner. And should you pull for him? No, because of the banner. Yes, if you want just to get him, I understand that. Mikasa. Mikasa, unluckily, is the worst character of the banner. I think because she has this weird ability where you need to have her cards in hand for her to deal extra damage, which all of the time doesn't work because it's all RNG. And overall, she could be decent with bleed for a single... For one versus three battles, like the final battle, etc. However, I don't think you should pull for her, because in blue we have already stacked units like Meliodas and... how she's called? The mage. I don't remember her name. Blue Lilia. Now I remember. And she's probably, however, the most sought unit in this banner, because she's indeed Mikasa. So should you pull for her? Only if you are here for your waifu Mikasa, I guess. Go for it. And then we have, need to stop switching banners, we have Levi. Levi is probably decent, it's the best way to put it. He's kinda like sort of debuff Jericho, where he has more debuff-oriented damage, however it is slightly worse than her. And he also has a cancel buff and stances on his ulti. Should you pull for him? Only if you like Levi, if you like his VR, which is probably one of the best voice actors in Japan, I really like his voice. Not because of this banner. So, in the end, should you pull? No, this banner sucks, you shouldn't waste your gems trying to get those characters, because that's what you will end up with. You will end up with one of those, I already tell you. You will. It happens. It happened twice to me. Even if I got Mikasa and Eren, you can safely get one of those characters. So wait for a better banner, wait for a step up. They are better for you as a player, and they give you also better units. If you are really a fan of Attack on Titan, you can roll. However, I suggest do it in moderation. Don't give them money for this trash of a system, of a banner. I always will say... Don't be negative, I'm not sure how to say it. Give feedback. Be positive in your feedback. Say that you don't like this, that you won't spend. Talk with your money. I didn't spend because it was free gems. So, just to say, I only spend in games that I really want to support, like Dragalia or Fate, for a different reason. Fate is way more scummy than this game sometimes, but I think if the game didn't get supported, it will really die faster than people think. Okay, so now we head into the end of the video, because there isn't really much else to say. I will try to cover the story, much like I did with the Tensura collab. hopefully it will take way less time than that, because hopefully they have time to improve their storytelling ways, which means that I have to make about 80 to 90 video fragments to put together, which is a tough job, let me tell you, especially when you work for free like I do. And I hope that you guys enjoy the fact that I will put together the story and other stuff for this collab. After that, I will try maybe to do content on stuff that I already have, but I really don't want to support the game if this is the direction that they chose to go with. I also am probably running out of free gems really quickly, so that's also an issue. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, guys. Sorry for the negativity at the start of the video. I just wanted to take out a little bit of a rant because this needs to be addressed in some ways, and hopefully if you guys feel the same, you will face your feedback towards the developers, and hopefully stuff will change without everything going negative. Thank you very much once again. I hope that I will see you next time. I hope that you have enjoyed the video for what it was enjoyable for. And if you did, and if you want to support me, remember to leave a like and a sub. And if you want to also do your thing and say whatever you want, if you are against what I said, if you support what I say, feel free to do so. I always welcome a nice discussion, just don't be too aggressive and negative like I was earlier. I really should have settled down a bit. Thank you very much once again. Hunter Lodge is out, and happy Attack on Titan collab for all of you Seven Deadly Sins players. Bye.